information. Let's say your server just took a dive, your firewall has just crashed, something's down. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna have to react. Well, let me tell you this. You won't be scrambling if your organization is prepared to deal with finding that information. So this is where that configuration management database steps in. It's your repository. It's going to be holding the authorized information relating to the organization's configuration items. And it's also going to be able to identify any relationships and dependencies between the configuration items. So for example, this application is dependent on this database, or this database is dependent on this storage array. So in reality, the configuration management database is going to be your one-stop shop for all of your configuration items. So those firewalls, the app containers, the routers. In reality, if it's something in your infrastructure, the details of that device is going to end up living in this configuration management database. So since that configuration management database is really just a repository, you can use something as simple as a folder on your computer to store everything. But let's be honest with ourselves here. That would not be following any ITIL best practice guidelines. So at a minimum, we really should be looking at a database. And that is an excellent starting point. However, true power from a CMDB today comes from implementing solutions that can represent the dependencies visually for us and automatically discover those changes to those configuration items that occur and update records as needed. So although the CMDB is a must, we really can't live without it. They do have their challenges. And these challenges include things like identifying where the